Welcome to the dock, harbor, and airport engineering. This is the general introduction about the airport engineering have two portions, dock harbor and the airport engineering. In dock and harbor, we are going to study the general history, development, and policy, classification of harbor, major port of India, administrative setup, harbor economic, etc. Then after, we are going to study how to plan a harbor. As a civil engineering, we have to know and use two of making sense of any planning and arrange the particular properties like that public can easily handle and easily operable. That's why planning is damn necessary for each and every component of planning, like harbor planning. In harbor planning, we are going to study harbor components. To plan anything, we can know just requirement. Then after, area, what to arrange, how to arrange, and when to arrange. What are the components of harbor? After knowing that, we can do planning easily. Without less of the knowledge of that, we can't plan anything. That's why we have to know harbor components, that sea characteristic of crude harbor and principle of harbor planning, size of harbor, site selection, criteria, and layout of the harbor. First of all, we have to idealization about the planning, how to arrange the component of harbor in a particular body. But first of all, we have to know the criteria of the land or area. Size of the area, shape of the area, behavior of the area, and the all direction of the area. Then after, we are going to make a rough sketch of the area diagram. And then after, we put all the elements, make layout of harbor with the help of principle and characteristic of the harbor, we are going to make a layout of the harbor. Then after, we are going to set our harbor components as that we can handle all the components easily, that we can make harbor planning. Now, natural phenomena in case of harbor and dock planning is why necessary, because there is some natural phenomena like wind, wave, tides, and current phenomena like motion of water, etc., are very affecting the harbor and a component of harbor. Also, the vehicles of harbor. That's why natural phenomena is also necessary. Next, marine structure. Design aspects of marine structure, breakwater function, types, general design principle, verbs, query, jetties, fire, firehead, dolphin, fenders, mooring, accessories, functions, types, suitability, design and construction, features. After making the layout and confirmation of the planning, we have to check natural phenomena criteria that it can't affect it at particular stage and how to register that natural phenomena from the body. That's why we can make marine structure to shelter the harbor. Now, docks and locks. Tidal basin, wet dock, purpose, design, consideration, operation of lock, gates and passages, repair docks, graving docks, floating docks, etc. Port amenities. Main purpose is the port amenity. The only portion for which we are going to design marine structure and the make layout and planning of harbor. Ferry, transfer bridge, floating landing stages, transit shed, warehouses, cold storage, aprons, cargo handling, equipment, purpose, and general description. Then after, navigation aids. Channel and entrance demarcation, buoys, beacons, lighthouse, electronics, communication device. Navigation aids are why compulsory? Because the navigation aids are the only way we are connecting with the surrounding harbors and docks. Also with people who need help, who require something, who wants to come, who wants to go, who wants to pass through, etc., etc. And the main and last portion of the dock harbor maintenance. કોઈ પણ વસ્તુને મેન્ટેન કરવી એ એનો નેસેસરી પોર્શન હોઈ શકે છે. એટલા માટે મેન્ટેનન્સ એ બહુ જ મહત્વની વસ્તુ છે. ધેટ વાર ધ મેન્ટેનન્સ ઇઝ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. કોસ્ટલ પ્રોટેક્શન, પર્પોઝ એન્ડ ડિવાઇસીસ, ડ્રીજિંગ કેપિટલ એન્ડ મેન્ટેનન્સ, ડ્રીજિંગ પર્પોઝ મેથડ, ડ્રીજિંગ ટાઈપ્સ, સ્યુટેબિલિટી, ડિસ્પોઝલ ઓફ ડિગ્રી ડ્રીજિંગ મટીરિયલ એક્સેટ્રા. Now we are going to start our new chapter, Dock and Harbor Engineering, in which we are studying the 8 points which we discussed already. Now, in first, general history of water transportation, historical development of water transportation in India, Indian water transport in India, major port in India, Port Administration, Indian Shipping, Importance of Water Transport, etc. History of Water Transport. In world, there is a three types of transportation mainly available. First, road transportation, water transportation, and air transportation. That's why this is very important. History of water transportation. Waterways have great historical impacts in the development of civilization and in the growth of nation, because the waterway is the only way which are very easy from the ancient time. because in Earth there is a 70% of water available and 30% of land available. It is said that ancient people utilize rivers and seas as their first facility for mass transportation of goods. It was only on river, lakes, and sea that heavy loads, timber, stone, grain would be carried in large quantity. Only light, valuable goods were sent over long distance by land, as is indicated by such name as Amber Road, Salt Road, or Silk Road. કોઈ પણ મોટું શહેર, મોટી સિટી, મોટું ગામ ત્યાં વસેલું હોય, એ જનરલી નદી, તળાવ ત્યાંના જોડે વસેલું હોય. પાણી એ માણસની પહેલી બહુ જ મહત્વની જરૂરિયાત છે, અને એ જરૂરિયાત ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશન માટે બી ઇઝી રહે છે. રોડ ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશનની લિમિટેશન્સ આવી જાય છે જ્યારે બિગ એમાઉન્ટમાં કોઈ ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટ વિસ્ટ કોઈ બી વસ્તુને ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશન કરવાની આવતી હોય એવા કેસમાં. એ ઉપરાંત એર ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશનની બી લિમિટેશન્સ આવી જતી હોય છે. ફર્સ્ટ લિમિટેશન્સ એવી ગણીએ તો ફ્યુલ, જે અમાઉન્ટમાં ફ્યુલ યુઝ થતું હોય છે ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશનમાં, એનાથી ઓછા અમાઉન્ટમાં વોટર ટ્રાન્સપોર્ટેશનથી ઇઝીલી કવર થઈ જતું હોય છે. નેક્સ્ટ સિવિલાઇઝેશન ધેટ લર્ન ટુ બિલ્ડ એન્ડ સેલ શિપ પ્રોપોઝ એઝ સેન્ટર ઓફ ટ્રેડ, કલ્ચર એન્ડ પાવર. એક્ઝામ્પલ ઓફ એન્શિયન્ટ સિવિલાઇઝેશન હુઝ નેવિગેશન હિસ્ટ્રી હેવ ચેન્જ ધ વર્લ્ડ ઇન્ક્લુડ ધ લેબનન, ફિનોનેશિયન્સ, ધ ઇજિપ્શિયન એન્ડ ધ વાઇકિંગ્સ. Ancient mariners used the sea to explore the world, trade good, and conquer their neighbor. In doing so, they spread cultural idea from one part of the world to another. The Tower of Babylon, which was really a six-step pyramid with a total height of about 100 meter, almost 33 feet, was an extraordinary achievement possible due to water transportation facility for transporting huge stone for this structure. Similarly, Egyptian king Cheops had the largest pyramid erected with a height of 146 meter, an area of 233 into 233 meter, and a cubical content of 2.5 million cubic meter. Such a task could only be accomplished with the help of aid of waterway. There are such many examples available in a history. Okay, we are going to skip rest of the data and next going to historical development of water transportation in India, which we start in a next lecture.